Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. This week we are in Japan visiting churches. As usual, we did in the morning training, we did prayer for members throughout the world while we are offering 120 vows devotion. Brothers and sisters, please know that we are praying for you and your families. We truly wish that you all live a blessed life and to be a bigger blessing to the world. Today we are truly welcome you to be in this sanctuary, and for those who are joining with us via internet, we also welcome you as well. Welcome brothers and welcome sisters.
Welcome brothers and sisters. I want to share with you from Chun Sung-kyung, page 339 today. Father says, are arteries greater or veins greater? Which is greater? They are equal. Then which is greater, God or people? They are equal. When it comes to love, if God is the artery, we human beings are like the veins. So we have the value of having the privilege to be God's equal. See, brothers and sisters, when we listen to Father's words, we understand that actually when we, in terms of love, when Heavenly Father looks at us, He sees someone with equal value to Him. And you may say, that's impossible. How can I be equal to Almighty God, the Creator of the universe? Of course, Father is saying, we may not be equal in His power. We may not be equal in His might. We may not be equal in His knowledge. But in love, you see, Father is saying, we can become His equals. We can share with Him the greatest power in the universe. Brothers and sisters, that's a very empowering statement that your parents are teaching us. They're saying that when we look at ourselves with God's eyes, we see someone with tremendous value, with cosmic, divine, unique value. We don't see, I can't do this right, or I don't have any ability or talent. No, we see somebody that is made, specifically handpicked for the work that we are to do here on this earth. Brothers and sisters, it's so important when we live our daily lives to see ourselves from that highest perspective, that divine perspective, to see yourself from God's viewpoint. Remember, that was the first stray of the fall, to not see from God's viewpoint. And so we want to make sure when we're living and we're actualizing the blessed life, we want to make sure that we're always looking at our life, ourselves, with God's viewpoint. You know, sometimes we may have obstacles, we may have challenges. Maybe sometimes we're not totally perfect. But when you look at it from God's perspective, we're growing, we're improving. You see, we're getting better every single day. We're getting stronger. We're getting more confident. We're getting brighter and brighter. Brothers and sisters, it's so important to see ourselves from this viewpoint. That really is the starting point for the blessed life. How we view ourselves, how it is we view our children, how it is we view our families, how it is we view our relationship to Almighty Heavenly Father. Brothers and sisters, today I want to invite you to not only observe service, but really participate in service. You know, when we pray or when we sing songs of worship, we really want to include, we want to invite you to participate, to be a part of that communion, to know, to let God know how much you love Him. When you do that, when you put your muster up your strength and give your effort to give God that strength in the very beginnings of this week, we believe that God will be with you with each step that you walk during this next week. Brothers and sisters, once again, it's such a delight to see all of you, and let's really not just observe service, but we're going to really participate in service. Let's have a great service today. Once again, welcome, brothers and sisters.
True Father said, family pledge is the highest prayer of all. So I'd like to ask you all rise up and recite family pledge number 5 and its own meaning together. Family pledge number 5. Our family, the owner of Chunhyogo, pledges to strive every day to advance the unification of the spirit world and the physical world as subject and object partners by centering on true love. But recite the meaning of the pledge as well. The mind is the subject position, and the body is the object position. Likewise, the spirit world is in the subject position, and the physical world is in the object position. Therefore, we should live a life on earth in accordance with the spirit world. We We should live lives of deep experiences through which we can feel the spirit world and God's sorrow and joy. Only God and true love can link the spirit world and physical world. We should strive every day to advance God's will. So we must advance towards God's will every day, even though it's only one step at
you. Brothers and sisters, let's join for prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for this day that you have blessed upon us. Today is a glorious summer day. Father, you are raining down upon us. Father, your love, your refreshing, everlasting life. Father, we feel revived in your presence, in the presence of our community, of our brethren, our brothers and sisters here, where we partake together in this communion. Father, let us truly offer our hearts to you this day. Let us know that you are dwelling with us at all times. Father, let us know that in every obstacle, every challenge, you are there walking with us. You are there helping us along that path. And Father, you are preparing us for a greater future. Father, thank you so much for this day. We are praying for each one of the brothers and sisters here today. We pray for their divine health. Father, we pray that they may have success and be blessed in all aspects of their life, physical, material, spiritual. Father, we pray that you may be with them at all times. Be with their children. Allow them truly to blossom, become the great creations that you have created them to become. Please be with all our brothers and sisters today who are joining us via internet across the world. We are praying with one heart, with one mind, and with one spirit today. Father, thank you for this day that you have blessed upon us. Give us strength today. Give us wisdom. Give us your everlasting peace. And we offer this with an everlasting love. In our names, we pray as Central Blessed Families. Adieu.